for joining us on yet another video about repairs with Repair Kopitiam. I'm Charmaine and I'm with Rahul, a Repair Kopitiam senior coach.
Hi, hello, I'm Rahul. I've been a repair coach with RK for a couple of years now. Nice to meet you all.
Rahul was just telling me something very interesting about our appliances at home.
Oh yeah, I was saying most of our appliances at home are usually heater appliances or motor appliances. Irons, kettles, toasters, I mean, these are heat appliances, whereas your vacuum cleaners, fans, these are motor appliances. And a hairdryer is a combination of both a heater and a motor appliance.
Wow, so interesting. So you will show us how to deal with heat appliances repairs?
Oh yes, let's try to fix an iron that we have and try to understand the basics of repair work.
Great.
All right. So this is a common household iron. So first and foremost, before we open up the iron, we begin with checking if there's power going to the iron. So we do that with a non-contact multimeter. So let me grab that.
Okay.
All right, so this is a multimeter and let's plug the iron in and turn on. Switch our multimeter to non-contact voltage. Test whether it's working. Yep. So whenever there's electricity flow, there's beeps. So let's check our cable and we see here that there's no electricity that goes to the iron in the first place. Okay, so since there's no power, let's start with the simple stuff. Let's start at the plug.
Okay.
So let me open the plug up and see if there's anything wrong with it.
Okay. What are you checking for right now?
So all our plugs here usually have a fuse inside and in this case, yeah, the fuse is fine. So
okay.
Yeah, I wonder what is wrong with this.
Mm.
Oh, wait. Oh yeah, I was too eager on the fuse that I forgot something very basic. I can see the live wire here is broken.
Okay. I see.
Yeah, I wasn't attentive enough in the beginning. So the problem can be much simpler than the fuse.
Okay.
So let's fix the wire back and see what happens.
Okay.
It happens.
Okay, so let me just check if it works.
Yeah.
Okay,
so let's see if it works.
Yeah, it works.
Yeah, so now we can see that there's power going through the cable. So the plug is fine and the power cable is fine all the way until the iron.
Okay, so actually the first step is to make sure that this thing itself is getting electricity.
Yes, that's right.
Okay.
So most of the time we are too eager to, you know, open up the appliance the moment we have a screwdriver in our hands. But the first thing to check, always start with the simple stuff, start with proper flow, and more often than not, the problem is much easier than you think. The appliance isn't even getting any electricity to begin with. So,
I see, yeah. Okay, now I understand. So we have to eliminate the possibilities first, and then we'll check the main body.
Exactly. Since there's nothing wrong with the electricity supply, it must be something within the iron itself.
I see.
Let's start dismantling the iron and then check the internals of it.
Okay. Oh, why are you taking photos of the iron actually?
Oh, this is good practice. So, since we all have a camera with us and photos are free, it's a good practice to take pictures of where every screw is and how everything is connected together. So this might come in handy and save you a lot of time when you're trying to assemble it back.
I see. So take a step-by-step photo of how we dismantle to remember the steps to assemble it back.
Yeah, that's right. It's very important we assemble back all the components that we take out and not put them in the wrong place.
Great. Now I know how not to have extra spare parts after a repair.
Yeah, that's right. You repair something 10 times, the parts are enough to build a model. So. Okay, so I do not see any obvious burn marks or any loose connections. So let's begin with checking our heating element.
Oh, okay. So how do we check the heating element?
Oh, okay. So do you remember your Ohm's law?
Yes.
Okay, so that's the basis of how we check a heating element. So remember, the value that we are trying to find here is the designed resistance of the heating element. So. Yeah, so let's read the label of this iron and we can figure some information from that.
Okay. So I see that the watts is 1,200 watts. It's between 220 to 240 volts and 50 or 60 hertz.
Oh, okay. So with a power of 1,200 watts, mm-hmm. and we know our supply here is 230 volts. Mm-hmm. So using the power equation, we know that current I is power divided by voltage, which mm-hmm. is 1,200 divided by 230. So the current is 5.2 amperes.
Okay.
So using Ohm's law, resistance is voltage divided by current, which is 230 divided by 5.2 amps. So the designed resistance is about 44 ohms.
Mm, okay.
So allowing for plus minus 10% tolerance, the resistance of this should be somewhere between 40 to 48 ohms.
Mm, yeah. Okay. So what are we looking for over here?
Oh, so since we've checked that the heating element is fine, mm-hmm. we will move on to check the other components. Mm-hmm. In a simple iron like this, it's usually a thermal switch and a thermal fuse. Mm-hmm. So let's open this up further and I can show you how to look at the thermal switch.
Okay. Right. What actually is a thermal switch?
Oh, so a thermal switch is a simple device. Mm-hmm. Its job is to control how hot your iron gets.
Mm, okay.
So the moment the heating element heats up the plate to a certain temperature, mm-hmm. and the thermal switch, once it hits the temperature that you set it at, it cuts off the electricity flow and mm. your heating element stops heating the plate.
I see.
And once it gets below a certain temperature, the thermal switch starts the electricity flow again and it heats up again. And this continues on and off all the way until you turn off when you're done.
I see, okay. So how do you check that if it's okay or not? Do we look for burn marks like you said just now?
The thermal switch itself, it's quite easy to see whether it's okay or not. So mm-hmm. we can just look at it visually, and by the looks of it, it seems to be okay. There's nothing obviously wrong with it.
Mm-hmm.
So the next thing we look at is a thermal fuse.
Mm, okay. What is a thermal fuse actually?
Ah, that's a good question. I have a spare thermal fuse here.
Okay.
So it's a simple device like this. Similar to any fuse, it's a safety device.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a thermal safety device. So the moment the temperature gets hotter than what it is designed to be, it blows and it cuts off the electricity flow.
Uh-huh.
So that saves the user from any possible fires because there was a fault and it just kept on heating.
I see. Okay. So we are looking for the thermal fuse now?
Let's check the thermal fuse with the multimeter. We see the thermal fuse is blown.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So what do we do now? What's the next step?
Oh, this is a very simple repair. Mm-hmm. I think once we replace the thermal fuse with the spare I have here, it'll work just fine.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Okay. All right, now that I've fixed the thermal fuse, let's plug this in and see if I've managed to solve the problem.
Okay.
Be on the safe side. Okay. And oh,
nice! It works again.
Yeah, it works. So it was the thermal fuse that was faulty. So let's put this back together and test it once more once you're done.
Okay. So in the meantime, so let's just recap on what we have done during this lesson. Number one, appliances are generally heater, motor, or a combination of both. Number two, we learned how to fix an iron, which is a heating appliance. How we did that was A. Check if the power goes into the appliance. Fix this if it isn't. B. Verify if the main component, the heating element, is working using Ohm's laws. Continue the repair if the element is working. C. Check other components, the thermal fuse and thermal switch. Thank you so much, Rahul, for sharing with us.
Thank you, it's my pleasure.
I'm Charmaine, and join me next to learn more about other repairs. Meanwhile, you can join the Repair Kopitiam community with these information.